ඒකයි බය නැතුව මම Nokia Android smartphone එක ඕන කෙනෙකුට ගන්න කියන්නේ.
සෑමදා අලුත් වෙන Nokia.
Former Health Minister Dr. Rajitha Senaratna filed an anticipatory bail application to prevent him being arrested over allegations made during a media briefing regarding white van abductions and robbery of gold belonging to late LTTE leader Velupille Prabhakaran. The Colombo Chief Magistrate, however, rejected Dr. Senaratna's anticipatory bail application when it was taken up for consideration on Friday, stating that the imposition of the clauses relating to the charges the ex-minister seeks anticipatory bail on, granting bail will carry a risk as it could be applicable to any other offence. Dr. Senaratna, however, went on to file yet another anticipatory bail application along with a newly amended affidavit in this regard. When the case was taken up today, President's Counsel Navaratna Bandara, representing Dr. Rajitha Senaratna, said that the first anticipatory bail application was rejected by the court based on a mere technical defect. The President's Counsel also noted that his client feels a reasonable fear of arrest on charges under Articles 485 and 192 of the Penal Code, while highlighting that these clauses are included in the newly amended bail application. Furthermore, PC Bandara stated that MPs and members of the Buddhist clergy are making derogatory statements about the arrest of Rajitha Senaratna through various media networks. As per Section 21 of the Bail Act, PC Bandara requested court to set a date for the hearing of the anticipatory bail application as well as to issue notice to the respondent party. Deputy Solicitor General Dilipa Piris, however, appearing in court, stated that the CID, who has been named a respondent, has sought assistance of the Attorney General. The Deputy Solicitor General also noted that the Attorney General objected to notice being issued to the respondent party pertaining to the bail application. PC Bandara, however, objected to the Deputy Solicitor General's submissions regarding the bail application. The Deputy Solicitor General also emphasized that the court should be mindful of the message being communicated to society through such anticipatory bail applications. The Deputy Solicitor General stated that the applicants of the bail application appear to have misused the specific legal status of the anticipatory bail set out in Section 21 of the Bail Act. The Deputy Solicitor General also noted that the anticipatory bail application is not a shield or a license that allows criminals to escape the law. After submissions from both parties, Colombo Additional Magistrate Priyanta Lianage, however, said that if requirements of Section 21 of the Bail Act have been satisfied, a magistrate holds the power to set a date to consider an anticipatory bail application. Additional Magistrate Priyanta Lianage stated that law does not stop an anticipatory bail application if it is not limited to the facts of a B report as well as even during the absence of a B report. Accordingly, due to the bail application meeting all requirements of Section 21 of the Bail Act, Additional Magistrate Lianage ordered notice be issued to the respondents of the case and scheduled 30th December for the next hearing of the bail application. Meanwhile, upon a request made by the CID this evening, the Colombo Magistrates Court ordered the Controller General of the Department of Immigration and Emigration to enforce a travel ban on Dr. Senaratna. The report filed by the CID highlights that the overseas travel of the ex-minister will hinder investigations as the media briefing conducted regarding the white van abductions was carried out under his patronage.
Maxis, number one tie in Sri Lanka.